So Lars, why do you think it's important for Danfoss to reach 30% females in leadership position?
We know from a number of different studies that a more balance between female and male will make stronger leadership team.
So how is it looking currently in your heating segment?
We have in heating 22% female leaders, but what I'm very happy about is that our talent pipeline, we have 24% female leaders. And you can say the talent pipeline is really the most important part for us to make those numbers even higher for the future.
And how is it looking at your top management?
Yeah, that's my weakest spot because we don't have a lot of female leaders in our top. But that is for sure, with the strong pipeline we are building up, will also going to change in the future. I actually also have a question for you, Ilonka. Where do we start?
I think it's a very ambitious target, so I think it requires an additional effort and a thinking out of the box mentality in order to get there. We need to make sure that these female candidates are at an early stage associated with Danfoss. We also need to make sure that females get coaching at Danfoss and mentors, male and female ones, for the females throughout their career. So for me personally, the vision actually is for 2025 that this topic is no topic anymore.